All right, Shalom, like to say, call Allah, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rakah Kadash, double honors to the elder apostles of Great Millstone, peace and blessings to all you brothers teaching in truth and sincerity throughout the four corners of the globe, underneath the standard and the banner of Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai. In lieu of that current situation in D.C., man, you know, you watch this Edomite kid give his interview and he's playing the victim all of a sudden. And we know how Esau thinks, man. Okay. But, you know, those brothers that gave, that I seen, that gave, the commentary on the situation, that brother Amawan Gabbar, okay, and that brother from what is it, SC Teacher, my brother's been out there diligently. Both of these brothers are solid in truth, man. Okay, and when I watched their videos, man, it enraged me, man. Okay. And I'm just here to shed a little bit just to the commentary that they put out, you know. And, you know, we all one body, man. And what I seen, I'm just going to bring it out, man. Esau being Esau. I don't trust this so-called white man because I know he's the devil. He's a liar, man. Okay, and I got scriptures to back it up, but you know, then you got these Negrolites. Okay, you got the Negrolite in the SC brothers' video with the Daishiki on with a mega hat on defending Edomites. Okay, and we know that that's rightfully so, man. 2/3 love Edom. Okay, they love America. We're black Americans. Okay, that's good and dandy. We love you to be black Americans because you're 2/3. You're gonna get destroyed anyways by the Most High because you can't come out of this out of the midst of Babylon the Great, man. Okay, you don't understand. All your factors are not kicking in your brain, man. Go back, okay, right here.
QuickBooks Self-Employed app allows me to take a photo of my receipts.
What's gonna happen next?
It's unclear from the videos who actually started.
Slucky.
And Phillips.
And what's it been like to be at the center of the storm?
Well, it's weird to see your face on television. I've been reading a lot. And, you know, I've also been getting a lot of messages from people, both support and a lot of hateful things.
Sandman and dozens of his classmates had just finished attending an anti-abortion March for Life rally when they converged with 5 Hebrew Israelites, a radical movement that is growing more militant, according to the Southern Poverty Law Center.
So the Southern Poverty Law Center, okay. We're growing more militant. And that just gives way to the prophecy saying that the truth shall be spread across the four corners of the globe, and then and Lord, that's one of the curses that he put on Esau, Edom. He was going to take the wisdom from Teman, which you're Edomites anyways, okay. So you don't understand words. You don't understand history. You don't understand anything. Okay? So now you're done. All right? So thank you for letting that known factor come out, because now the end is about to come. Okay, World War III. Your prophecy of the RFID microchip. Okay. Pestilence upon the face of the earth, which you created. Also, okay, through Monsanto's, the CDC. All right. Yes. The Hebrew Israelites, through the spirit of power. Of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. We're not ignorant of Satan's devices any longer, okay? And it's known, man, okay? But that's another show. I'm just going to go on with this one, all right?
They started shouting a bunch of, you know, homophobic, racist, derogatory comments at us.
What kinds of things did you hear them say?
I heard them call us incest kids, bigots, racist. They called us
a bunch of incest babies, a bunch of child molesting.
Did you feel threatened at all?
I definitely felt threatened.
There were more of you than them, but you felt like they were stronger?
They were a group of adults, and I wasn't sure what was going to happen next.
It's unclear.
I got a scripture on that one right there. A little quick precept. Okay. And I'm going to bring out the rest of this. You know. I got scriptures upon scriptures here. You know. But I'm just going to get down to the scriptures that I got. Let me see. It's Psalm 58 and 3. It says, the wicked are estranged from the womb. They go astray as soon as they be born, speaking lies. Okay? And that's what he's doing, man. Now he's playing the victim. Okay?
Clear from the videos who actually started the confrontation. Each side believes it was the first to be taunted. Sandman says his chaperone gave students permission to shout school chants, an attempt, he says, to drown out the Hebrew Israelites.
Do you think it was a good idea to start chanting back at the protesters?
In hindsight, I wish we had just found another spot to wait for our buses. But at the time, being positive seemed better than letting them slander us with all of these things. So I wish we could have walked away.
Did anyone shout any insults back or any racial slurs back at the group?
We're a Catholic school and it's not tolerated. They don't tolerate racism, and none of my classmates are racist people.
Did anyone say?
Okay. And I'm gonna show you right now why they full of bullshit. Okay. So this is a Twitter snippet. Okay, from theroot.com. Okay, and it says it's a video, which I don't have the video feed. Okay, because I didn't want to show it. I don't know what YouTube's going to do to that. All right, but you brothers can probably type it in and get it up there. But this is from Marcus Weber. Okay, it says from 06 to 106, you can see a teacher or coach. That's this guy. All right. Teacher or coach, Covington Catholic, leading the teens in a chant. All right. Just like you seen. All right. And he said, none of my friends. At this game, black players on the opposing team were verbally abused. Why? If they're a Catholic high school that don't tolerate racism or a profanity. Okay? What's going on there? Alright? So Esau's caught dead to rights, man. He's a liar. Alright? And that's pretty much it. You know what I'm saying? We know how Esau gets down. He's the victim always. He never wants to say, well, this is what happened, and you know, I'm that guy that did this fully and blatantly, okay? That's why we got this right here for you you coons that protect so-called Edom, all right? It says Ecclesiastes 12 and 10, never trust thy enemy, for like as iron rusted, so is his wickedness. Yeah, it's going to appear, okay? It's not going to diminish. It's not going to go anywhere. This is who he is. This is the way that the Most High has made him, okay? He is the wicked, okay? Verse 11, though he humble himself and go crouching, yet take good heed and be aware of him. And thou shalt be unto him as if thou hadst wiped a looking glass, and thou shalt know that his rust hath not been altogether wiped away. Okay? Set him not by thee, lest when he hath overthrown thee, he stand up in thy place, neither let him sit at thy right hand, least he seek to take thy seat, and thou at that last remember my words and be pricked therewith. Okay, so no matter how nice Esau tries to play, he hates you, man. He's not your friend. Okay, when he looks at you with your mega hat on, okay, Make America Great Again hat, he says, what a stupid asshole. Stupid, stupid, stupid. And he'll give you the thumbs up. Because Esau's a crazy, deranged sociopath, man. Okay? When you look at Esau, think of the Joker. Okay? From Batman. He'll give you a job, but he's going to kill you in the end. All you niggas siding with Esau, y'all think that's going to make Esau kill you when he comes down having great wrath? He's going to kill you too. You bird brain Negroes, man. Stupid as shit, man. And we love it. The Hebrew Israelites, the real Hebrew Israelites, we love it. Because we can't wait for 2/3 of you to get wiped out, man. Because the scripture says so in Hosea, okay? It says, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge, man. If you don't have the knowledge and wisdom and understanding of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, through these scriptures, through the man of the Lord, you're as good as dead, man. Period, point blank, man. So get that right, man. And this devil over here sitting in here, and I got another scripture. Let me just get it. Slocky. This is Psalms 55, okay, and 21. It says, the words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart. His words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords, okay? So when we go back to the video, all right, listen to what he says.
Build the wall.
I never heard anyone say build the wall, and I don't think I've seen it in any videos.
After a review of the videos, NBC News could not hear anyone shouting that hot button phrase. But Nathan Phillips claims he heard the teens shout, build the wall.
Oh yeah, I heard that.
Phillips was with a group of Native Americans coming from an Indigenous People's March when he can be seen walking between the students.
So my thing is this, right? Why were they even around with MAGA hats on in the first place. And it was an indigenous protest going on there the same day. Okay. Esau is a devil, man. He likes to lie, man. He likes to lie, and he likes to say, oh, that's not my intent. I didn't do that. That's what this scripture means, man. Words in his mouth, I mean, Slocky, the words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart. His words were softer than oil, yet they were drawn swords. Them teens, okay, they came there for a confrontation, okay? They wanted something to pop off, okay? That's how I see it. They didn't know that it was going to be actual cameras there, man, taking footage. Okay, they didn't know that the real Hebrew Israelites was going to be there. The Lord set Esau up perfectly, man. Okay, to be further exposed in his youth, okay? So you Edomites, y'all done, man. All around the board, y'all getting exposed left and right. Isaiah the 46. Okay? On the face of the earth anymore, man. Everybody's going to start chanting the same thing. The so-called white man is the devil. And then, furthermore, after when they look up the history of the Hebrew Israelites, okay, and why we call ourselves Hebrew Israelites, and why we call ourselves the 12 tribes of Israel, okay, which the biblical names are going to come up, okay, then they're going to find out that your biblical name is Esau, okay, which is the progenitor of the nation of Edom, okay. Just like they're going to find out that the 12 tribes progenitor was Jacob, whose name turned into Israel. All right. So with that, I want to say, Ka Allah, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rakah Kadash. And hey, Esau, you ain't got no birthright. You ain't got a prayer and a hope. You ain't got nothing. But one thing you're going to get is a foot in your ass by Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai. All right? The saints shall take the kingdom. That's what it says in the scriptures. And with that, I want to say Shalom.